Hey friends, welcome back to Beer and Beauty. It's Kasha. Today's libation of the day is a wine from Boggle Vineyards. Looks like this. It's a Cabernet Sauvignon. Let's give it a taste. Cheers. It's good. It's a good Cabernet Sauvignon. I actually bought the Merlot that comes from this brand, and I don't know what was up with it, but it tasted so sulfate-y, so I wasn't really into that. But this one seems a little bit more black cherry tasting, a little bit more like a wine. It just tastes like a wine. But I don't know what was going on with the other one, but it was it tasted pretty sulfate-y at first glance. And as you can see, I just finished this bottle because today is November 4th, the Wednesday after Election Day. It's evening time, there's still no clear winner as to who's gonna be our next president, and the anxiety levels are high. But I wanted to go ahead and shoot this video because it's November, and this is a favorites video, by the way, and November is the month of gratitude, right? It's the season of feeling grateful for things. And I haven't done a favorites video since June. I just checked back on my account to see when was the last time I did a favorites video, and it wasn't since June, so I figured it's a good time to think about things that we're grateful for right now, because depending on who wins the election, it might be a lot harder to feel grateful for things in a day or so. So without further ado, let's get into our favorites. Favorites since the last time I did a favorites video. The first favorite I'd like to talk to you guys about is my beautiful hair. As you guys probably have noticed in my last couple of videos, I cut off all of my hair, so it's like really short, and one of the main reasons I wanted to do that was so I could start wearing more wigs. And this is probably the most fun wig that I've been wearing a lot lately. I've also really enjoyed this wig that you've probably seen me wearing in my special effects kit video. I was wearing this hair, but also in a bunch of makeup looks that I did for my 31 Days of Halloween project, which was also one of my favorites. I did quite a few like really fun makeups, but I'm gonna talk about that later in the video. But yeah, this wig I bought originally because I wanted to do like a TikTok with my boyfriend's niece, where she would be Ariana Grande and I'd be Lady Gaga. And this is the only like blue and purple wig that they had at the store, but it's still like so fun. I was wearing it a lot during the summer. Of course, I wasn't going out a ton, but I did go to the beach one day, and I was skateboarding around. Actually, twice. I went to Venice Beach to go skateboarding, and then I went to Hampton Beach to go skateboarding. Socially distant, of course. If you're gonna be in a crowded place, for sure, wearing a mask, even if you are outside. That's been my MO, at least. Yeah, and I definitely turned so many heads with this hair. This is such a fun wig. I feel like a whole different person. I feel like a party girl when I wear this hair. And yeah, I wore it in the fun, like super fun music video that me and Mike did while we were in Venice Beach after we drove back from Massachusetts to LA, because I spent much of the summer back in Massachusetts where numbers were low and where my family was, and that's where I turned 30. I had my birthday. My birthday was amazing. Well, not amazing, but it was good. And yeah, and I wore this hair in a photo shoot that I did with a friend of mine, just because I wanted to have, I've never really done a professional photo shoot, and I wanted to have some headshots for possibly putting on a business card. And then a few of the shots had me wearing this hair, and there's one shot of me that is just epic. I think I look so beautiful in this picture. I might throw it up on the screen. Yeah, it's gonna be my profile picture on Facebook for a long time, I think. So I have, this hair has brought me a lot of joy. I feel like I said, like I've such a, like this is so much fun. I feel like such a party girl. And then this one is just very glamorous, very Morticia-esque, very long. I just feel like I also feel so beautiful wearing this one as well. And yeah, I did quite a few makeup looks on Halloween with this wig on. Maybe I'll throw up those pictures up on the screen to show you guys too, but that wig has also brought me a lot of joy. There's other wigs I have that I haven't worn as much. These were pretty much the main two I've been wearing, and I feel like they're gonna be fun to have for future things as well. The first favorite was probably the wigs, but you know, now that I'm thinking about it, now that I'm talking about the wigs, I realize that cutting off my hair this summer is also a favorite, because it makes it so much easier to just slap a wig on. But not only that, but I think it looks super cute with my short hair. It's felt like when I first cut it all off, it felt super liberating. I've always struggled with my hair. I've always thought it was too thin. It grows so slowly. It's always been very fine and brittle and breaky. So to just kind of free myself from all the negative feelings around my very fine, breaky, hard to grow hair and just cut it all off so I can be wig girl. And also just, have short hair during the super hot summer. It's actually really hot right now in this room. Even though it's been getting chillier out in LA lately. Like last night, I almost considered putting on the heat, but then I didn't. Yeah, cutting off my hair was another favorite. Highly recommend it. I've been able to really kind of like treat my scalp too, because I have a lot of scalp issues. I've got psoriasis on my scalp and stuff, so it's been really easy to get in there with like scrubs and serums and different detoxifying shampoos and different things to like treat my scalp, and I feel like my scalp is getting in a lot better shape. Slowly but surely it's getting better, so cutting off my hair and the wigs, like those things go together. I guess the next favorite thing I'd like to talk to you guys about is just the various projects I've been up to. You know, as we speak right now, the pandemic is still going on. Unfortunately, the numbers are starting to go up here in LA, but they were staying pretty steady for a long time, so I was able to do a few fun events. I was very choosy about the events I took on Halloween weekend. I chose to only do one event per day, and I did a beautiful skull makeup just this past weekend. That's one of the best skull makeups I think I've ever done for a client. I think I might throw that up on the screen. I also did a 31 days of Halloween project on my Instagram, and I think a lot of the photos that went up with that were really awesome. They also included a couple of photo shoots that I did over the summer, including the photo shoot that I did of myself for with my cool hair, which is probably one of my favorite pictures of myself ever, and also just the photo shoot that I did of myself like soon after I cut my hair, and I can't remember if it was before or after my birthday, but I did turn 30 over the summer, and strangely, I don't feel like an oldie just yet. When the big number arrived in my life, it felt kind of weird, just like, wow, my 20s are really just over. This is it. My 20s are over, but I still feel vibrant and youthful. As a matter of fact, I've been getting back into, like, taking care of my health slowly but surely. It's been a rough week with all the things going on, but I've been getting it back into that stuff, so I've been grateful that I've been able to maintain my health. I've been taking care of myself. I've been jogging a lot throughout the summer and just keeping up with my vitamins and drinking water and all that stuff. So I feel like I don't feel like I'm middle-aged or anything like that yet. So that feels good. That's been nice, and it was nice to be at home and being able to visit my family during my birthday as well. So yeah, that's cool. But I also did quite a few other beautiful skull makeups that you can see up on my Instagram. I've been posting a lot of the makeups I've done throughout the summer and throughout the fall. And a lot of them I'm very proud of, like that skull makeup. I also did a beautiful mask makeup on myself that was a little bit of like a artivism kind of piece. It was like, it was meant to make a political statement a little bit, but in an artistic way. So I had a lot of fun with that. I enjoyed that quite a bit. I also shot a COVID friendly short film while I was out in Massachusetts, and that was really fulfilling. And yeah, the photo shoot that I did with my friends, like it was like a voodoo photo shoot in the woods with one of my friends. It was just great to, it was a great way to just hang out with some of my friends and create some artwork and get some really cool pictures out of it too. So you guys can go ahead and check out my Instagram to see those pictures. They came out amazing. Lots of great work came from this year and I'm so proud of them. Can't wait for you guys to see it all. It's gonna be great. Okay. I think the last major thing I'm gonna talk to you guys about is that over the summer, because I drove out to Massachusetts to spend the summer in Massachusetts, and then I drove the summer, drove back, I tried to like make that road trip a little bit more worth it by seeing some nature, you know, doing some outdoorsy stuff, because doing indoorsy stuff was kind of not really an option, not a safe option at least. So I did see a lot of national parks, and I got this national park pass. So I've already, this year, as of yesterday, because I went to the national park yesterday, this year I visited 5 national parks. All of them are absolutely incredible. Like, this is such a worth it purchase. Like, this has brought me so much joy, this annual national parks pass. This allows you to go visit any national park. It costs $80 for it, but for a year you can go visit any national park inside the United States as many times as you'd like. So, I actually didn't buy this the first national park I went to, but as the first national park that we went to, me and Mike went to Yellowstone National Park, where we saw some buffalo and lots of sublime landscapes, including some very volcanic ones. And we saw Old Faithful erupt, as well as some other geysers erupt too. And like, I always thought going into it that, of course, seeing a volcano erupt, it's gonna be really cool. And I always knew that Yellowstone is gonna be like, every national park I've ever been to, I've been to quite a few, has been sublime and just felt amazing to be there. It makes you feel like the world is such a gigantic, amazing place. And Yellowstone was no different. And actually, I knew I would feel those things being there, but once I was there, it was even more amazing than I thought, you know. Some of the geysers were like crystal clear, some of them were very sulfury and smelt disgusting, and some of them looked like this gorgeous shade of blue, like turquoise blue, and I just wanted to go swim in them because they were like bubbling, and I figured like, oh, they must be so therapeutic and nice. But you know, I'm sure there's a reason that you're not supposed to go in them, because not only just to protect the landscape, but also it's probably not safe for some of them, but yeah, a lot of the geysers, the volcanic activity was just so eye-opening, how powerful of a force nature in the world was, and Yellowstone was just amazing, and I definitely recommend it as like a vacation for a family to go to. It was a little bit more crowded than I would like, but everything was obviously outside. People were pretty much mostly wearing masks, so I didn't get COVID from being there, and it was really cool. And then at the end of the summer, on the way back from Massachusetts, we stopped in Mesa Verde National Park, where we saw some of the America's largest cave dwellings, and also a bunch of very sublime landscapes there too. The Mesa Verde cave dwellings were so enlightening, and it was so cool to see that history in America and those ancient ruins. Like, seeing there's nothing quite like seeing a 1,000-year-old ancient ruin. It felt a lot like seeing the Colosseum when I went to Rome a couple years ago. It was equally as much of a sublime experience, and that was amazing. And then the following day after we went to Mesa Verde, I had bought my National Park Pass at Mesa Verde, and then I went to, with Mike. Mike was making the trip with me to and fro. But then we went to Bryce National Canyon, and my gosh, the arches that were there were so beautiful, and just the pillars, I forget what they actually called them. Oh no, my light, my soft box is about to burn out. Can you hear that? It's so loud. Excuse me. Damn. Well, I hope you guys are okay with me only doing the lighting changing now, because one of my softboxes just burnt out, and it was so loud. I didn't want it sounded like the light bulb was about to explode, so I think I'm just gonna leave it off. And I hope you guys are okay with that. Maybe I'll just turn up this light a little bit, and that will make up for it a little bit. I don't know. We shall see. I brought in one of my umbrella lights a little bit, and I don't know if that will help, but... Moving on. Bryce Canyon was beautiful. I also have some beautiful pictures of that as well. A lot of these I haven't even posted to my Instagram yet, but I plan to do that a little bit throughout the month, just to express a month of gratitude, which is what November might be all about. We shall see. I'll try. I feel like that's going to be a good way to just kind of like decompress after the year that 2020 has been. We shall see. But when Mike finally went back home to Massachusetts, September and October have been very stressful, especially with the election coming up. I decided, I faced a little bit of bad luck, quite a bit of bad luck. My car is falling apart, and somebody actually hit it while it was parked. Luckily, one of my neighbors came and saved me and got the guy to stay and called my landlord, who later called me, and I came out to, you know, regulate the situation. And I was able to get like the insurance information from this guy, I had to get my car worked on for a week because the bumper was all messed up from that accident that happened to my car while it was parked. But in the meantime, they gave me a rental car, and I figured I didn't want to like do door dashing and weird stuff like that with a rental car. I did a little bit, but it just felt weird because I wasn't completely like used to the rental car in the way that I'm used to my own car. You know, I've only like had a rental car like two other times. One other time because of an accident, and one time I rented one with my friend when we went to the Grand Canyon together. I figured, what do you do with a rental car and some free time? You go on a road trip. So I decided to leave LA for the day and go to Joshua Tree National Park. Also another really sublime place. The Joshua Tree's really a beautiful landmark. And I grew such like a big appreciation for the Joshua Tree. Like I've seen the Joshua Tree, like little guys, in the desert 1,000 times, but just seeing them in this like crowded landscape and all these boulders, like a bunch of rock climbers were scaling up these boulders, it was peaceful and it helped me decompress, and it was just incredible and amazing, and I highly recommend Joshua Tree. And finally yesterday on election day, my anxiety was just through the roof, and I figured a good way to get my mind off of like racing all day long and making my anxiety levels go through the roof, I decided that it would be nice for me to check out some sublime nature. So I went to Santa Cruz Islands, the Santa Cruz Island and Channel Islands National Park, which is off the coast of Ventura, California. And that was absolutely sublime. The water was so beautiful and clear. We saw dolphins. The dolphins were like interacting with the boat that took us to the national parks. And they were like jumping out of the water, and they were squeaking, and they were so cute. I love the dolphins. And then we got to the island, and the beach was just so clear, and there was all these seashells and all these like pure like rocks, like it was like a rocky beach. And then I went to a different part of the beach, and they had these beautiful whirlpools that had all these like little hermit crabs and like living plants inside the whirlpools, and just the way, and these caves were everywhere along the beach. and the way that the water was swelled inside the caves and then exited the caves, and like, and the wildlife that lived inside the whirlpools that were inside these caves that were so incredible. And one of the highlights of that trip was also I got to see a super rare fox species. The Santa Cruz Island fox is like a little 4-pound pop fox, little cute little baby, only exists on this island. It's super rare, it doesn't live anywhere else in the world. It only lives on Santa Cruz Island, and I saw two of them, and I took some pictures of them. They were so sweet and cute and little, and I can't believe I saw two of them. It was so incredible. I think that's everything, guys. I talked a lot. Oh, actually, I guess I'll throw in a couple extra things before I go. But yeah, those were like the main things that were my favorites in the last couple months. That's a little bit of a check-in about what I've been into, how I've been coping with my anxiety, coping with what the kind of year it was. The good thing about a National Park Pass is like you can travel and it's safe and you can socially distance and it's outside, and it's incredible. And it doesn't actually cost that much money. Like once you have this, this has already paid for itself by visiting more than 3 national parks. So I've already visited 5 this year, so I've paid for itself, like this has already paid for itself and then some, and I plan to visit a couple more. I'm actually currently training to possibly go hike the Sierras. Right now, I don't know what the fire situation is like, but I'd like to go, once the fires get under control, I'd like to go visit Sierra National Park before the end of the year, or just another national park. There's so many in the Southwest to explore, so I'd like to go visit another. Like a quick lightning round of things I'd like to mention. The lipstick I'm wearing, I got these 2 lipsticks on Ulta that were recommended by Hannah Louise Poston, and she did not disappoint. Like I got the Maybelline lipstick in Gone Grage and Raw Chocolate. Both are incredibly flattering on me. This one's a little bit more edgy. I'm wearing this one today, the Gone Grage. When it comes to like edgier looks, this is like always a really great choice, and then the Raw Chocolate is just like a beautiful, very flattering brown lipstick nude that is delicious, and they both smell good and they're moisturizing and they're comfortable to wear. These are really great lipsticks, love those. And then this sugar scrub from Tree Hut on Ulta, and this is the vitamin C sugar scrub. This is another item that I picked up in the last Ulta haul that I did, if you want to check out my last Ulta haul. And I am always excited to use this. Like every time I get in the shower, I'm just like, yay, I get to use this. My skin turns out so pretty after I use it. So like, it looks a little bit brighter and smoother, and it's like evening out my skin tone, which is actually really important to me because I often get like psoriasis, and when the psoriasis heals it leaves like white blotches, so it evens out those white blotches quite a bit, and it's nourishing, and it's not very messy in the shower, but it gives you that like a really strong exfoliation nonetheless. And just another slam dunk out of Tree Hut, and they're at a great price point too, so I really recommend that. And the third thing that I got from the Ulta haul that I constantly just keep reaching for is this CBD facial oil from e.l.f. I still can't tell if the CBD effects do much for me, but I keep reaching for it. Maybe it's just because it's new, I don't know, but my skin seems to really like it. I still haven't figured out if it's really an anti-inflammatory. It hasn't really done much for my like psoriasis that's along my hairline here. But yeah, another thing that I keep reaching for, and I feel like I've made a couple good decisions in that last Ulta haul, especially because it's probably going to be the last Ulta haul of the year. So if you're expecting more haul videos out of me, I don't think you're going to get them. But I will be talking about a lot of products that I've been really enjoying a lot lately in my next empties video, which is coming up soon. So check that out. Subscribe if you like empties videos, so you get notified when that comes out. But that is it, guys. Let me know down in the comments some things that you have been enjoying and have felt grateful for in recent months that are getting you through this year and these trying times, these highly anxiety-inducing, trying times. Maybe I can get some cool ideas out of you. We can bounce off of each other some ideas. That would be super cool. But yeah, that is it, guys. Thanks so much for hanging out with me. I hope you enjoyed hanging out with me. I really enjoyed hanging out with you. And until next time, cheers and happy Thanksgiving. Early Thanksgiving. It's not here quite yet, but it will be here soon. So happy early Thanksgiving. Love you guys. Bye.